So this hadith, my beloved brothers and sisters, is really, really important to remember that the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us commands, order, صلوا, pray, perform salah, establish the salah. كما رأيتموني, as you see me praying. So as a Muslim or as a believer, very important that every single one of us to make sure that how the sunnah, how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed the salah from takbir, Allahu Akbar, to at-taslim, to assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So for me to learn, I really, really important to review the salah. Inshallah, I will give you a little information with demonstration. Then inshallah, I show you also video in order that the, in your mind will be established very well how to perform salah. And today, each one of you, you should make a checklist. Where is my mistakes when I do salah? If I have a mistake from today, you analyze your mistakes, and from today, inshallah, you can correct it and you don't repeat the same mistake in future. My beloved brothers and sisters, in Islam, when I come to do salah or perform salah, I really need to have wudu, purification, as one of the conditions for salah, and cleanness, and also remove any dirt, and I should have clean clothes, and I also should face al-qibla for the prayer. After this, when I come to do salah, I say, firstly, takbiratul ihram, Allahu Akbar. And in the sunnah, my beloved brothers and sisters, we have two ways when I say Allahu Akbar. First, I can lift my hand up like this, all next to the shoulder and like this, as you are submitting your will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, full of submit, plus as you're throwing all this dunya behind your back. As you're throwing all the dunya, all the money, everything in the dunya is not worth that you are going to pray to the Creator and Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I do like this, Allahu Akbar. Say Allahu Akbar. So some people, they make mistake. They do like this, is wrong. All I do like this is wrong. All I do like this, just Allahu Akbar like this, is wrong. You have to do like that, okay? You can be near your ear or towards your shoulder. Both of correct. Also, when I do Allahu Akbar, in the Takbiratul Ihram, which is the first Takbira, will be more higher than the normal, the other Takbira. The other Takbira, I say Allahu Akbar, little bit, it's okay. But Takbiratul Ihram, I lift more up. More up. Then I say Allahu Akbar. And there is two ways to perform your salah. Al-qabdu wal-bastu. Al-qabdu wal-bastu. What is the meaning of al-qabd? What is the meaning of al-bast? Boys, please. Okay. Al-qabdu is you put your hand together like this. You close. That's what we call it in Islam, al-qabd. So I can do like that. I can show you. Allahu Akbar, like this. The right in the over the left, and I close like this. This is we call it al-qabd. And I can put it in the upper shoulder, middle shoulder, in the shoulder. All it's okay. We have narration from the Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So this is a qabd. The other way also valid from the Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, al-bast. What does mean bust? Means straight. So I can do like that. You see? This one here in the upper, I'm like that. So also this is a one-way valid and acceptable to perform salah. Can you see me here, brothers, sister? Like that. This is we call al-bast. So if I do like that, or I do like that, is correct. No any problem. So in the salah. Also, there's a hadith like that. Also, it's all right. But some people, they make wrong. They do like this. It's wrong. It's like a hadith. This is not. Or they do like that. They didn't put the right over the left. Also wrong. And some people, they put the left in the top of the right. Also wrong. Okay, how about do like this? Also acceptable in the salah. So we say Allahu Akbar. Then after the dua of istiftah, which is sunnah, for example, we say Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik wa tabaraka ismuk wa ta'ala jadduk wa la ilaha ghayruk. This is one of the dua istiftah, or also there is other dua from the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of the Imam Ibn Qayyim mentioned more than 3 or 4, all is narrate the dua istiftah. To start with the dua, okay? This is a sunnah. If you miss it, your salah is still acceptable, but better we learn the sunnah and we not miss the sunnah, unless if we are really in big emergency. Then we say Allahu Akbar, and we start after dua al-istiftah, Surah al-Fatiha. And we need to recite it, not too fast, but slow, and we need to remember that when we recite Surah al-Fatiha, we have the khushu' and our mind with us, Where common mistake, my beloved brothers and sisters, especially boys and girls, when they pray, their mind is not in the salah. They thinking about the play, or about food, or about something. And even as adults, wallahi, sometimes we thinking about our business, about job, about kids, about what will happen about this. This is a salah, is for Allah. You are offering your salah to the Creator Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you correct your salah, wallahi, you will find a lot of peace and khushu' and tranquility and happiness. Subhanallah. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say to Bilal, arihna biha ya Bilal. Make us relax with the salah. Why? If we understand the khushu' and my mind, my heart is there in the salah, I will feel relaxed. I will feel what? I will feel relaxed. So we say Allahu Akbar and we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmi Ad-Din. Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Ihdina Siratal Mustaqim. Siratal Ladhina An'amta Alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. So we start Surah Al-Fatiha. So did you see me? I do the qabr. Also I can do the bust like this. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Both is correct. When I stand for salah, my beloved brothers and sisters, one of the common mistake, some people, they will open their legs too much like this. So what will happen? I become shorter. Then the one next to me, he will be very far from the shoulder, which is wrong. Some people also, they close their legs. So when they put the shoulder with the other person, there is a gap. The correct way, the qama is like this. What is the distance between this shoulder to this shoulder? It will be the distance between my right foot to the left foot. And subhanAllah, my beloved brothers and sisters, ulama, they very care. They say, the right qama, the right straight, when I am standing for salah, it's four arms, like this, I can show you. Each one of us, his hands, if we open from here to here, is the same of our tall. Same of our tall. For example, we have 4 ibham. Look, I hold this one from the right, all the way here, this is one arm. This is one arm. So is my straight should be how many arms? According to Fuqaha, 4. 4 arms. So I can do for test. Let's test. 1, okay? Here, 2. I hold. 3. And this is 4. So my tool until here. Can we check? Can you see me? I will put this one in the ground, here from the ground, and I put like this. Shofu? Is it 4 or not? See, if I open like this, I become shorter. I will not become 4. If I do like that, become taller, which is not correct. So I should be like this. So from here, from the my top of my head until the ground is four of my arms. Okay? And this is the sunnah, that the way you stand, وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. You stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with khushu' and straight. It's not like this, or feel lazy, or you act like you're going to salah like some people, like they trying to be lazy. No, stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala firm and with khushu', with humble. And your eyes, where should be? مَوْضِعُ السُّجُود. Where usually you sujood? Your sight there, but not like busy, what is happening there in the ground, but just your eyes. If I try to look, I will see my sujood. I see my sujood, like this. See my eyes down where I do sujood. Okay, some people misunderstand. They say sujood, exactly where is I make sujood all the time, focus like this. It's not that what the Rasulullah meant. What the Nabi meant, that if I try to look, concentrate, whatever, it's my sight is there. But my mind is not what is there. My mind busy with khushu', that I'm praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm busy with the verses, with the ayat, with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Then we say Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. We finish, then we choose any surah, for example, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد or any surah I can recite is acceptable. So sunnah to recite something after Fatiha. Last time one of the students, because he's always rushing, الله أكبر, then I ask him, why you don't read any surah? He said, it's sunnah. My salah will be accepted if I don't recite any surah. Yes, your salah might be accepted if you don't recite any surah after Fatiha, but this is not the sunnah. If you make it once in your lifetime, you are busy, something happening, okay. But every time you just Fatiha, Allahu Akbar, no, you should do the salah with the sunnah to recite something after Al-Fatiha. You understand, ya Habiba? You say, read some surah, whatever, and some salawat, it's okay to take long. Not all the time, my salah is very fast or very short. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some salawat, they account like 60 ayah. And even Qiyamul Layl, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he prayed Surah Al-Baqarah, wa Ali Imran, wa Nisa, three surah in one rak'ah, and two rak'ahs. Three surahs, the longest three surahs in the Quran, which is equivalent around 60 pages. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he prayed with two rak'ah. So we need really to practice to stand long in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have the khushu'. Then, my beloved brothers and sisters, how to do ruku'? Ruku' is wajib, rukun. You must do ruku'. If you miss the ruku', your rak'ah is not valid. You need to repeat the rak'ah. So when I want to do ruku', I lift my hand up. No need too high. It's like takbir al-ihram. Less is okay. We say Allahu Akbar. We say Allahu Akbar. When we start Allah, until the word Akbar R, I should already perform. So my voice, when I am saying takbir, it's moving. I start with moving my part. We say Allahu Akbar. So when I say R, it's I'm already in ruku'. Some people say Allahu Akbar, then he go. It's wrong. Or some people, they go like this, then when he's here, say Allahu Akbar. It's wrong. You understand? So when I move to ruku', I start Allahu Akbar. You understand? So don't say Allahu Akbar, then you go ruku'. And don't make ruku' first, then we say Allahu Akbar. It's wrong. Then when I perform ruku', I should make sure my back is very straight. Very straight. Like this. Allahu Akbar. I try as much I can to straight my back, and I also with the head. If I do like this, it's not straight. If I do too high, my head will be above my back. I will be not straight. Even they describe Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Sahaba, if you put a water in his back, will not drop. صلى الله عليه وسلم. He سبحان الله he pray in amazing way. Some of us we fat little bit, choppy. Sometimes we find difficult, but you need to practice as much you can until you perfect your ركوع. Perfect your ركوع. Huh? When we do ركوع, Allahu Akbar. What I say in the ركوع? سبحان ربي العظيم. سبحان ربي العظيم. سبحان ربي العظيم. Glory be to Allah, the greatest. Glory be to Almighty Allah, He is the greatest. Glory be to Allah, He is the greatest. Al-Azim. When I say the dhikr, I should feel my heart is there praising Allah. My heart is there to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then when I do the ruku', make sure I have tuma'nina. What is me tuma'nina? Tuma'nina mean a moment where you feel you relax while you are performing this ruku'. You feel like you are relaxed, your body relaxed, not like this. And some people they bend their knee like this. It's wrong. You have to straighten your knee, and it's okay to hold like this or hold like this. Both is correct. And you do the ruku' and make sure you have a relaxing moment. So some people they do like this, they doesn't go down. Like that is wrong. Or you do too much, wrong. Or you bend your knee is wrong. Or you bend like this is wrong. You understand? You have to make sure your legs straight and you do the ruku' and you relax for a moment. Subhan Rabbi al-Azim. Don't say like this. Allahu Akbar, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar. Your back haven't have tuma'nina, which is a moment of relaxing. You make sure that your position doing ruku' get the right timing. Right? Timing. You know what mean right timing? Not like this rushing. It's like a naqruddiki. You know the rooster, how he eat? You know the rooster? Chicken. They do like this. And they rest up. Some people they pray like this. Oh, what happened to you? It's not correct. You have to take the tuma'nina for ruku'. So when we say Allahu Akbar, we did the ruku', Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Then we start standing after the ruku'. We say Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. Say it together. سمي الله لمن حمده. You see when I say that, I'm already stand. Don't say سمي الله لمن حمده. Then I stand. It's not correct. Or I do like this. سمي الله لمن حمده. No, I start when I say the سمي the S start. I start moving. I start moving the position from ركوع to stand. Also, I need to make sure, my beloved brothers and sisters, that my back straight, 100%. Some people, they say, like do like this. سَمِعَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْحَمِدَةِ. Like this half of the way, 45 degree, then they go, Allahu Akbar, to the sujood. Which is really wrong. لَا صَلَىٰ مَنْ لَمْ يُسَوِّي ظَهْرَهُ بَعْدَ الرُّكُوعِ وَبَعْدَ السُّجُودِ. Salah is not valid for a person, he doesn't straighten his back after ruku' and straightening his back after sujood. Salah is not valid. Ya Allah, I do 10 minutes salah, then my salah, throw it on my face like this. Salah, your salah is not valid like this. It's not accepted. Throw it in your face. There's really, really many people, sometimes wallahi, many people, they inform that they've been 40 years doing salah wrong. 40 years. Subhanallah. How long you never try to learn and read and see how the salat should be performed. So alhamdulillah, you come here. It's a beautiful moment today to revive the salat. So when we left, we have to make sure my back is straight. My back what? Straight. Okay? Very good. Al-ruku'. Then we go to the sujood. My beloved brothers and sisters, for sujood, when I say Allahu Akbar, the time I say the takbir, I move to the position of sujood. And when I do sujood, my beloved brothers and sisters, I have to make sure seven parts of my body must be in the in the ground. Seven part of my body in the ground. According to the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَسْجُدَ عَلَى سَبْعَةِ أَعْظَمْ. I've been ordered to make sujood over seven parts of body. Seven parts of body. Who can tell me the seven? What is this? Yes. Forehead and nose. This is one part. الجبهة والأنف. جبهة mean the forehead and the nose should be on the ground. واليدان, the two hands. والركبتان, the two knees. And القدمان, the finger of the foot. Oh, foot finger. So one, two, three, four. أيوة. And the knee, five, six. And this one is one. So how many now? Seven or not? Yeah, this is one, two, three, the knee, four, five, and the six, seven, six, seven. So my beloved brothers and sisters, I can show you the demonstrating here how to do a sujood. You can look at me, we say Allahu Akbar, then I will make sure I do the sujood correctly. This is a qibla, my head here, the forehead and my nose, my two hands and the knee, and also my finger of my foot. Some people, they make wrong that they left their legs not, up. They doesn't put their legs on the ground. And some people, they do so, it's like a sleeping on their stomach. And some people, they are so tight, which is wrong. We need to make sujood. How many arms? How many arms? Three arms. As we learned before earlier, that when we stand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should have from the head to the foot, how many? Four arms. But when I make sujood, how many arms? Three arms. Okay, let's see. What is a three different thumb arm? This is one, two, this is three. So until here, this is the tall from the head until my foot when I'm doing sujood. Can you see? Look, I put in the line here and here. This is how I do. I am here standing. Look at how I do my sujood. Where should be here? I close my foot and here. Is it the same? Almost the same. This one is not here in the jabha. Okay? Look. From the line until here is my jabha. Can you see? Did you understand? Three arms. So I don't make my beloved brothers and sister that I will do too tight like this. Some people I see, can you see what they do like this? They put their knee with their stomach. This is wrong. Some people they do too fast like this, which is really wrong. It's not a push-up exercise. This is sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another people make mistake. They put their hands on the ground totally, all the arms, not the hand, the arms totally, they put it that like this. Can you see me? Brothers and sisters, can you see?
Yes.
This is the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited to do is like the dog. To do like the dog. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the ilqa' of kalb, like the dog. You know, the dog always sit on his arms like this. So also wrong. Also, when we come down to the sujood, one of the big mistakes, my beloved brothers and sisters, if you can see me, that some people, they, when they sit to the, going to sujood, they make a big sound. They throw themselves with their knee down like this. And they didn't do sujood. This is, it's wrong. This is the how the camel. Have you seen the camel when they sit down? They do like that. So they do like that. This is totally wrong. You make a big sound as you throwing your knee on the ground. This is wrong. All also they throw their themselves to their hand like this. Make like the camel. This is not right, but the right way we do like this with with the correct. It's okay to start with knee also mention, or you start with your hand, but in the light way, not the duck throwing. Also, you can do like this together, The hand first, then the knee, or also the knee or the hand. It's okay. Both is directed, is correct. As long as not copy the camel. Copy the camel. In the sujood, my beloved brothers and sisters, when we make sujood, this is the best time to do dua. Best time to do what? Dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After we say Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, we can have plenty of time to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. According to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the closest moment between the servant and Almighty Allah during his sujood, during his what? Sujood. Like you are making sujood to Allah, you are so close to Allah. You are so close to Allah, and you can ask Allah anything.
That I am now in the sujood, after I say Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, I can make dua, Ya Allah, forgive me, rahm me, provide for me, whatever I need, give me guidance, have mercy on me, forgive me,
whatever dua you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the best position. You feel the closeness between the servants and Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So far, I give 2 minutes to ask questions before I move forward. Any questions so far, my beloved brothers and sisters? Yes, brother.
In Jama'ah, when did you start moving to sujood?
After Imam.
Imam finished movement or when Imam is on the way down?
When the Imam finished Allahu Akbar, you move after him straight away. Not like waiting. Like when he said Allahu Akbar, you start moving after following the Imam. Follow. Whatever the Imam does, you follow. Don't wait long and don't compete with him. There's a hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, competing the Imam, your salah is not going to be valid. Your salah is not going to be